With the Big Four Fashion Weeks fast approaching, we've taken it upon ourselves to do the very important task of warning you to beware of following fashion trends. What's hot today may look like a hot mess in the future, and we're here to serve you a proof. Welcome to the Bestest, the channel that provides you the bestest news and videos you should know about. Today, we're doing a quick run through of 15 of the most horrible fashion trends that do not deserve a comeback. Before we start, make sure to like our page and follow us for more amazing videos. Ready? Okay, but before that, here's the challenge. We dare you to tally the number of items on this list that you are guilty of having ever worn. After the video, tell us in the comments how many you got. We can't promise not to cringe, but we'll try not to judge. We're not too innocent of committing these fashion crimes ourselves. Let's get the cringe fest going with number 15, t-shirts over long-sleeved shirts. The only reason this was mentioned first is that it's nowhere near as silly looking as the others on this list, but that doesn't mean it makes any sense. If we have someone to blame for this trend, that'd either be Jennifer Aniston or Jared Leto. But come on, that's them. They can pull off practically everything. But everyone else, whoever did this, owes us an explanation. Beyonce also has some explaining to do, but for a different trend. At number 14, bandana shirts. Remember how back in the 90s, bandanas and crop tops used to be the big staples? Now, we're okay with that, but then came in the 2000s when some genius decided to take the two and combine them into this awkward trend that we're all glad is all in the past now. Think that these are bad? These are nothing compared to the next ones, especially number one. So make sure to stay till the end of this video so you know which fashion pieces you have to ditch. And that includes shirts with ties at number 13. Okay, don't ditch the tie. Just maybe wear them with polos and suits like any normal person would. Ever since pop punk princess Avril Lavigne did it on her Skater Boy music video, the angsty youth of the 2000s started wearing ties over their shirts too. I don't know who invented ties, but if it were me, this is gonna make me want to sue someone. Like whoever came up with the idea of, at number 12, jumpsuits for men.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Jumpsuits used to be a fashionista's wardrobe pick back in the 70s, and while we're all for men expressing themselves, this trend was simply tragic. Many of the jumpsuits are even brightly colored, so they look more like costumes that simply didn't look good on most men. Lucky for them, the trend didn't last too long. But some of these trends haven't totally gone extinct yet, just like our next one. At number 11, overalls, but with one strap down. Not sure if it was accidental or a conscious choice, but once upon a time in the 90s, Will Smith decided to leave one of the straps undone on his good old-fashioned overalls. High school students everywhere loved it, and soon everyone was leaving their houses looking like non-symmetrical farmhands. Though not considered as hip anymore, there are still a few people who did this. His son, Jaden Smith included. Making it to the number 10 spot, we have real fur. Yes, it was once considered cool to wear clothes and accessories made of real animal fur. And for some people, it's still maybe. But thankfully, this trend is finally being put to rest, with major clothing brand states and even the Queen of England herself pledging to stop producing, selling, and wearing them. And why not? There are two reasons we hope this trend remains out of style for good. One, these cute and innocent animals don't deserve it. And two, these cute and innocent animals don't deserve it. What other reason do we need? I mean, just look at these things. Number 9, trucker hats. Wow, can you believe it? No one thought to take inspiration from Bud Light guzzling truckers until the 2000s. And we blame one man for making trucker hats hit. Yep, Ashton Kutcher. We mean you. Almost overnight, everyone was obsessed with trucker hats, from Von Dutch to DIY airbrushed ones. And for reasons we don't understand, they wear them sideways. Pretty soon, even the ladies were into it too. We're halfway through our list, and if you've made it this far without a single point on your tally sheet, stick around for the rest, especially number one, because we're sure you've owned at least one of those on our top spot. At number eight, we have wedge sneakers. My brain refuses to understand why this was ever even considered cool. Nothing about the wedge sneakers makes sense. Still, you gotta admit, you probably either owned or wanted one. Wedge sneakers first became popular in the 40s, then made a comeback in 2012, with celebrities like Miranda Kerr, Dakota Fanning, Nicki Minaj, and the Queen Bee herself clunking up and down the streets with Isabel Marant's hidden wedge platform sneakers. Now, a lot of women are swapping out their tired old wedge sneakers of seasons past for simpler, classical kicks. Now, that is the fashion redemption arc we deserve. Next up at number 7, gaucho trousers. When the designers at J&Co first popularized the gaucho trousers, they were probably going through some sort of identity crisis. Because why else would you design pant legs that looked like skirts? I can't imagine the number of times parents would roll their eyes every time their kids' tree-trunk-sized jeans get caught in the car door. Or whenever their head-banging festival-goer teens come home with pant legs marinated in mud and poured up potty souvenirs. Another pants trend we'd like to forget at number 6, Hammer Pants. When MC Hammer released these pants in the 1990s, kids and teens of all genders and races thought they were so cool. Never mind that they make your body proportions look way off, or that they make you look like ancient Chinese emperors or something, or that they're like saggy diapers with legs. MC said they were cool and the world listened. But what trend did we replace it with? At number 5, we have saggy pants. Dear pants designers in the 2000s, you had one job. No matter how cringeworthy the gaucho trousers and MC Hammer pants were, at least they did their job of covering your underwear. And what are those back pockets doing all the way down to the back of your knees? These saggy pants are not only hideous, but also impractical when running, or walking, or trying to get a job, or looking like a person who takes a bath. Okay, we'll stop here. And nope, we lied. We're not yet done with weird bottom wear, though this one was more popular with the ladies. At number 4, we have low-rise jeans. And we mean the very, very, very low-rise jeans that Kate Hudson, Britney Spears, and Christina Aguilera loved wearing in the 2000s. Not sure if they just want the world to know that. Hey, they're wearing underwear, see? As a side note, it's also weird how the pendulum swung the other way around about a decade later, when high-rise jeans became all the rage. I mean, what do ladies have against jeans that sit comfortably at the waist? There's something about the early 2000s that just got us making bad fashion decisions, just like the velour tracksuits at number 3. At some point along the way, staring at women's butts went from sleazy to unavoidable. The culprit? These velour tracksuits with suggestive words printed across the butt. Bonus points if yours says juicy. With socialite pop stars like Paris Hilton, Mariah Carey, and Kim K popularizing the trend, owning an expensive velour tracksuit became women's way to say, "Hey, I put the cash in casual." Thank goodness this fad has dwindled down a bit. Walking up to the number 2 spot, UGG boots. No, that's not short for ugly, but we getcha. Are they warm? Sure are. Are they comfy? Super. Do I own at least one pair? I invoke my right against self-incrimination. When UGG made their way from Australia to the US, the trend just spread like wildfire. It's when we saw these Uggs on people from countries where they don't have winter, paired with short shorts or skirts. That's when we realized that people are just wearing them to agitate fashion experts. But if you never owned one of those, we're sure you were unable to escape the fashion fad that is shutter shades at number 1. Two questions. What and why? What exactly are these shades protecting your eyes from? Nothing. So why wear them? This is not a rhetorical question. We're really asking because we're just dumbfounded. They're sunglasses, but without the lens. They have plastic frames, but they don't completely cover your eyes. I'm so confused. Who would want a striped tan on his or her face? So when Kanye West popularized these shades in 2007, the lesson we learned is never assume you can go from rapper to fashion designer overnight. Alright, how many points did you get? Let us know in the comment section below. If your tally sheet is still blank, it's either you're in denial or you have a time-traveling machine that helped you see which trends to avoid. Just like this 1,000-year-old mummy who was wearing what looked like a fresh pair of Adidas kicks. Curious? Watch our video on the top 10 proof of alleged time travelers in history. Don't forget to like and subscribe to The Bestest and make sure to hit the bell to access more of our videos. Thank you so much for watching, and until our next Bestest video.